situate with us.
Welcome to a production of Tabitha Television. Coming up is an interview with Open University student Tempe Williams as she speaks with us on her life in the United Kingdom.
Hello, my name is Tempe Delois Williams. I'll be 57 years young next week. And I'm from Memphis, Tennessee in the United States of America. I'm a student at the Open University. I came to the United Kingdom in 2007. I wrote my first novel, Feelings, and it was published 2006. I actually met my then fiancé, Albert Williams, through our publisher. He had just published a book also. I met him in 2005. We got our books published in 2006. He proposed to me in 2006. I came to the United Kingdom here 2007, and we married actually 2008 here in the United Kingdom. Yes, I'm born in Memphis, Tennessee, in the United States of America. And the oldest of five siblings. I had two brothers, two sisters, wonderful parents who raised us with high values, educational values. I graduated from Jeter High School. Was actually our last high school class in 1972. And then I went on to Lemoyne College and received my Bachelor of Science degree in natural science, concentrating in pre-med, and graduated with honors in 1976. So it's been 35 years since I've been in higher education right now, and delighted to be in Open University. But my parents, both of them were very, very instrumental in all of us. And being the oldest, I just was very proud. I was the first one in my family to receive my degree, and all of my brothers and sisters thereafter received theirs from the same university. My brother currently is the director of admissions there now. But just moving ahead, to let you see, I spent 25 years in Memphis, then basically wanted a career change, wanted to get into sales and marketing and management. And it was just an exciting part of my career. I became the marketing manager for a German-based company called Forwerk, who relocated me first to Florida, then to Kentucky. And I learned a whole lot. And the company went folded. So I basically was left with the experience and being very ambitious and a go-getter. I decided to visit Chicago, not knowing that I would stay there the next 25 years. But getting my background back into order with my science and health care, I had also, before I left Memphis, worked at Baptist Hospital for 12 years as phlebotomist. So I knew I could do that. So when I got to Chicago, in addition to working for cable TV, I also still wanted to keep grounded in healthcare. So I started working for West Suburban Hospital. And it was at West Suburban Hospital that I never will forget. I was in a QA meeting. I was the manager of phlebotomy, the outreach lab where we contracted 12 nursing homes. And I was in a QA meeting, and my dad actually, I had gotten word that my dad had been rushed to the hospital. He had started getting sick. He had a heart attack. And about a year prior, my mom was severely diabetic. She had a stroke, and she became blind. So both my parents were critically ill at the same time. And it put me in a position, being the oldest, with no family. I knew I had to go back home, so my boss and everyone was very supportive. I had to quit my job and relocate back to Memphis to care for my parents. And I think that that was a turning point in my life. In fact, it's very traumatic because during that time, I think that one of the reasons that kept me grounded was my being and have worked in healthcare. I can't say enough about Open University. I'm very excited. I've actually been accepted, and I'll be working on my master's degree in the master's program. But like I mentioned, I've been out of school now 35 years when I got my BS degree. So, and being in another country, different cultures, I decided the best thing was to start taking an opening course first. And I will be taking, starting November 1st, Y-159, Understanding Management. And I'm just very excited. This will help myself as well as my husband in our business, Diablo Tay Television, where we both are open university students. Some tips that I'd like to pass on from experience and just from learning, especially watching my husband now. Number one, I call it the 5 P's. Prior planning prevents poor performance. I think that in studying, to make sure that you have the right attitude, first of all, that you're motivated and that you're around motivated people. You keep yourself motivated. Time management will be very, very important, especially at a distance learning institute, university like Open University, to be able to have to juggle family and all other life experiences. I would suggest time management. Make sure that you find the appropriate time that you're most effective. Along with time management, organizational skills. Make sure that you're organized. Whatever it takes, then do it. And one of the things that I've learned from my husband is to use your time effectively. You don't have to spend a lot of time, but the time that you do, make sure that you find the peak time that you're at your best. And when you're at your best, to make sure that you read over the materials, you review it, you take notes, you highlight things along the way. And that you read for an understanding to comprehend rather than just memory. One of the things too, Open University supplies you with so many tools. And another tip is go along with your planner to make sure that you're on target with the planner. It's great to learn ahead and to use the internet and other resources, but make sure that you stay on target with what your tutor and the program calls for. I'd like to thank my husband, Albert Williams, who is a student in the 156 digital film course. I'd like to thank him for taking the time out and allowing me to be interviewed, to express my thoughts. I'd like to also thank Open University for giving both of us an opportunity to not only grasp a bigger and a better understanding in the digital world, management world, but just self-development. Thank you so very much.
Greetings in the name of His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie. This is just a promotion to promote Dread Rastafari Ethiopia, a publication written by myself and I and I Queen, Ras Albert and Empress Tempe. Dread Rastafari Ethiopia will be a concise and comprehensive historical report on the Rastafari movement in Dominica. We expect the publication to be out within the next 2 years. We shall be looking at personages like Desmond Trotter and the going-ons of the Dread Act and much more. So stay tuned to Dabbleted Television. We are here for your success, uniting communities globally. Tempe made her way to the Queen Square, where she entered Connections office to speak with Sarah Passwell of the West Green Community Centre.
We're in the process of setting up a bigger and better steering group, because now we have better representation. We call it a BME working group.
Okay.
And what the plan is, I mean, really, it's about giving. For me, it's the BME community, a bit more of a voice. I'm not from that culture.
Yes.
So yes, I'm happy to facilitate the meetings, but I want more representation from that community, so that we can make events like this bigger and better every year. Now I must say that we've had a small working group, and from that working group, this has been the outcome today, has been the outcome of that small working group. But the plan is for next year to make it so much bigger and so much better.
Yes. Well, from what we understand and from seeing your brochure, it's very impressive.
We've done really well, because this is about the community putting in their time for nothing. We've given a few resources here and there in terms to help them with the promotion of their schools, but certainly their time has been their own, and we're very grateful and very thankful for that, because at the end of the day, if we work with the adults, we infiltrate their young people, because remembering that we are a service for young people.
Next, we spoke with Bert Williams of Brighton and Hove Black History.
Yeah, black and minority ethnic history. I do research and look at the contribution they made to our beautiful city.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes, and nobody knows how much they contributed.
But, it's time for a change, and that's part of what all of this is about.
Exactly.
And to answer your question, we're representing, we're television and video television. We're up new, not new to what we do, but new to the community. And what we'd like to do is to be able to add to what you just said and what Sarah and Pat just said. We'd like to bring awareness and educate people, not only in the community of the local talent that we have, but take it abroad on an international basis, because it's so many things that we've got going, and unless people don't even know it, and there's no voice to let them know that unless someone takes a stance and start it.
Mm-hmm.
So my husband, you see him there, Albert, we're doing a documentary right now and of this event that we ourselves just found out about. And we'd like to be able to put this, we're going to expand on that so that people know about it. We'd like to get your card in the wheel.
Yes.
Okay, come on.
not talking about
that's
that.
That's okay.
A little thing about Haile Selassie, I mean, if you're a West Indian, you're...
My husband.
Are you? I'm a Jamaican, so it means much more.
Respect.
Well, when Italy invaded Ethiopia, Haile Selassie came over here as a refugee, and he was over here for 5 years. And he spent a lot of time in Brighton, and that's the king and his wife and two sons, with a mayor Brighton outside the Royal Pavilion. This was during the Second World War.
Yes.
And this is the king in Haile Selassie at Holmes Farm in Hove, visiting a place. And now, while he was in Brighton, he was a regular church goer. And he went to a church in Brighton, in West Street, called St. Paul's Church. And while he was there, there's a plaque inside the church to commemorate the generous gift towards the repair of the tower of the church.
In 1947.
His contribution. So he was in Brighton. That's him on Brighton Pier. That's a photograph of him on Brighton Pier. And there's a pier and everything, and that's him.
We'd like to say a few words, so
we'll
step
this way. Thank you very much for coming.
Hello everyone, I hope you can all hear me today, because this is the most wonderful opportunity for us all to get together and celebrate the Black Culture History Week this month. The food here is amazing, I hope you all have a chance to sample it. And the drumming earlier was absolutely fantastic. I really think this is an opportunity for us to get together and celebrate. And I hope it's the first of many events and I see it growing bigger each year. And so thank you to the organisers. Thank you to the cooks, all those who brought food. And just a huge, huge thanks to everybody. And thank you to everybody for coming along to participate. I think we've got some wonderful things coming up soon for us all. So don't go away. Stay on and watch it. And join in. Thank you.
Profound, and
for us as well. You see, and like you say, there's so many of the little things that we take for granted, and just to be able to have a forum and a gathering in a common place, we like to, I know on behalf of my husband, on behalf of SBTV, we like to thank you and Crowley for allowing this great event to take place.
Your head. jump like a kangaroo, jump like a kangaroo, jump like a kangaroo. Bimba bimba, oh yeah,
yeah.
Bimba bimba, hey. Oh yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Jump, jump, jump. Jump like a kangaroo. Like a kangaroo, jump like a kangaroo. Do the kangaroo, do the kangaroo, do the kangaroo. I met this lady from Australia. She come to England for the carnival. She heard a lot about West Indians. Really love the festive traditions. And when the woman never still and play, and see West Indians start to move and sway, the lady could just not resist. She jumped right into the bacana.
Hey, hey,
the
hey.
Woman jumped like a kangaroo, jumped like a kangaroo, jumped like a kangaroo. All day long, the woman jumped like a kangaroo, jump like a kangaroo, even through a double-decker bus. Hey! She said she really loves sound systems and the colors of the costume then. She even singing the calypso with rhythm and with much gusto. And when the soca rum get to her head, she reach out and she grab a drink. She asks, are you from Jamaica or Dominica? Because I'm looking for a rasta man. Hey, the woman jump like a kangaroo. She jump like a kangaroo. Jump like a kangaroo. All day long, the woman jump like a kangaroo. She jump like a kangaroo. Even jump with the river turns. Hey, yeah. Now if you see a woman jumping like she's crazy, it's the lady from down under. Nothing like this in Australia, partying with wild abandon. It's the spirit of emancipation. Every race, creed and class in Notting Hill, London. It's the spirit of a Caribbean man captivating the whole nation. See the woman jump like a kangaroo. She jump like a kangaroo. Jump like a kangaroo. All day long, the woman jump like a kangaroo. She jump like a kangaroo. Even jump over long. Yes, she jump like a kangaroo. The woman jump like a kangaroo. She jump like a kangaroo. Jumping like a West Indian. Hey.
do the tango, do the tango, do the tango, do the tango, jump, 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 do the tango, do the tango, do the tango, jump, 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 like a kangaroo, 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 do the 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 kangaroo, jump like a West Indian, the people jump, hey, people jump. I want you to, I want you to, I want you to jump like a West Indian, hey. Jump, jump, do the kangaroo, do the kangaroo, do the kangaroo, do the kangaroo, jump like a kangaroo. Jump like a kangaroo, 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 do the kangaroo, do the kangaroo, I want you to jump like a kangaroo, jump like a kangaroo, jump like a kangaroo, do the 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 kangaroo. Jump, 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 we jump, we jump, we jump, we jump, we jumping like the West Indians. Jump, 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 jump.